Welcome back to Let's Play Torment, Tides of Numenera. I'm the RPG Chick, and we're going to talk to Dracogen finally. Let me just take a quick look. We're going to hand him, well, I guess the magmatic amulet. And it's in the Ascension. The cortex as well. We have to do this at some point. The infested fathom. Whenever I die again, I guess. Okay, Dracogens. And then he'll help us, supposedly. He's gonna help us get into the... get an audience with the Memovira. Well, Castoff, what news have you? Have you managed to obtain the cortex? Or are you ready to surrender the amulet? Well, number two would be a lie. We have it. I brought the cortex in which to trade it in place of the amulet. Would you accept the cortex that we discovered earlier in place of the amulet? Or just give him the amulet. So what's the real difference between 1 and 3? I wonder. Wish to trade it. Tell him my wishes or ask him. Let's be firm then about our desires, I guess. I brought the cortex and wish to trade it in place of the amulet.
I'll remember that.
Huh. Got some XP. His smile disappears as he considers your words. He licks his lips nervously and places his hand to his forehead as if he was suddenly stricken with a headache, or if he were communicating. He looks up after a brief moment, his smile returning, though not nearly as wide. Your words are wise. I will accept. He places it into a flat pouch at his hip, and no shape distorts the pouch as if it were merely a gateway to some other place. Ah, he's got a bag of holding, right? Oh, well, sorry, this is not D&D. This is Numenera. So he thinks, in all caps, acceptable, but not ideal. Take it. There will be other opportunities. Okay. So I've gained 100 experience and... okay. This concludes your part of the transaction. Let me honor mine. Come with me. Alright, now we're getting places. We finally got to talk to the Memovira. That's exciting. Hey, hey. This way. Draw any weapons and you'll die in short order. Okay, make sure not to do that. You heard me right, Aretas. I know you're the very soul of action, but really. The Memovira is a medium-sized woman, regal in bearing. She scrutinizes you with a look that manages to convey both admiration and disdain. She thinks, so she escaped Milavest. A shame she chose to come here. Oh, so she knows who I am, apparently, and she knows that I was at Milavest, and she knows what happened to Milavest. Though her words are cultured, her voice is rough, perhaps an artifact of low upbringing. Dracogen was effusive in his praise for your skills. I've been following your movements myself. You move the trade post out of the depths? There are very, very few people who could manage such a feat. Perception check tells us that the way she looks at you and holds herself suggests that she might be wary or even slightly afraid of said accomplishment. She thinks, the bloom has surely turned against me if she can do what I could not. Yeah, wary. Afraid. Maybe even a little jealous as well. Her eyes are piercing as they sweep across you. I've dealt with cast-offs before, of course. I found your kind to be tenacious, resourceful, and skilled, and I know the one you are looking for. I can tell you where she is hiding. We are looking for the first. I'll just choose. I am grateful for any help you can provide. Gold tide. Here we go. I'm sure you are, she sneers. Unfortunately, I am not the one to give my secrets away for free, especially not this secret. I understand that this first castoff has been hidden from your kind for over a century. Rest assured, I have no qualms about betraying her, but the cost will be steep. I have lost someone, an important member of my organization. You've no doubt heard of the recent changes in the Bloom. Perhaps you have even heard the rumor that it has turned against me. To some extent, that is true. Ishen is a victim of that betrayal. Ishen? We haven't met an Ishen, I don't think. She looks at the floor, saddened. Ishen was my best scholar, a genius with the Numenera. Through my own means, I've divined that he still lives, but I cannot reach him. The Bloom has taken Ishen to its heart. I have lost more men than I care to think about while trying to recover him. As a cast-off, however, you have certain advantages my minions do not. Her tone becomes curt. With the recent fluctuations in the Bloom's layout, I no longer know the path to reach the heart. I suggest you talk to someone who knows the Bloom well, if you cannot discover the way yourself. She thinks, I can no longer afford to send anyone who is not otherwise expendable. Yeah, let's bypass this for now. I had a few questions, actually. I do apologize if I gave the impression that this was a discussion. Her voice hardens. I have made my offer. Rescue my friend from the Bloom's heart, and you shall have the location of your precious first. Fail, and you will not. Do I make myself clear? Her voice returns to its ordinary tones. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have an organization to maintain.
Making a note.
She addresses her guards. See that the cast-off doesn't get lost on her way out. Nice. All this time and to meet her and we didn't even have a real discussion. At least according to what she said. So to find Ishen in the heart of the Bloom? Well, I can level up and so can Eritus.
Yes.
So let's do that now. All I have left is extra effort. So yes to that. Ooh. Abilities to learn. Resourceful. Right. Additional ciphers. That's kind of low on my list. We do need to use ciphers whenever we're in combat next. Could stand to use a couple of them. Choose a damage type. Confer energized. Scanning array. Gain a plus 5% bonus for each level of effort applied to perception, lore, machinery, mystical, and natural. Plague spirits. Infuse critical hits with entropic forces, conferring disrupted on top of the normal effects of the ability. Entropic forces destabilize the target, causing negative effects to increase each round. This is new. Hedge magic? At least I don't remember seeing it. Automatically succeed on the next quick fingers or smashing task. It's really Eritus that usually smashes things. Quantum step, teleport, entropic field. Incite action. Target an ally with enemies in weapon range, then choose one of those enemies. The chosen ally makes an immediate attack on that enemy. That's pretty cool. I like that. I kind of like that. So their strength becomes my strength. Maelstrom? Yeah, I know that. I think Kalistis has Maelstrom, I think. Datasphere Link. Plus one training level in lore machinery, mystical, and natural. That's pretty much the same as... Oh, that's a 5% bonus, and this is a plus one training level. Unstoppable force. Gain plus 2 damage on esoteric attacks. It's only +2 damage. Too bad it didn't, like, scale or anything like that. Like, a certain amount per level. Even just one per level. I'd definitely take it. Gravity manipulation, successive attack. When you kill an enemy, immediately it makes a bonus attack into the nearest enemy in range without moving. Applies to both melee and ranged attacks, which I'm usually just using spells. So, I'll get 2 points too. Okay, incite action. If you use critical hits. Bonus per level of effort. Oh, it's perception, and then those lore. Maelstrom. Maelstrom and insight action. Done. Okay, and Eritus. That's an increase in ability or a skill. Endurance, initiative, running, healing, persuasion, or smashing. Or I can do abilities. Fell swoop. Not a whole lot of choices there. Fell swoop. So right, we use that occasionally. I'm choosing carefully, because who knows if we're ever going to level up again. Initiative. Initiative I'm gonna take. So a better chance to attack earlier. Okay. Now, does anyone have anything to say about what's going on?
Yes, lass.
Oh, we haven't asked him about little Nylash. You know, and we haven't asked him about Artaglio either. At least I don't think so. You know Artaglio from before? Oh yes. Knew him during my brief stint in the Endless War. Did not cover himself with honor, but then no one did there, and if they had, no one would have noticed, what with all the shrieking and madness. He frowns. He's always been a bit morose and prone to drink. Might be because he cares, or did once. He thinks he might actually be a better man than me. Fancy that. Yeah, past tense. At least, well, he might still be alive. One of the Maws took him. Tell me about little Nylash. Ah, mutants. Life isn't easy for them, but the stories I have from parties in Nylash would peel your ears off. He shrugs. But they're not all shameless hedonists. More's the pity. I was once mugged by a man with three arms, eyes? While his kneecap kept an eye on the alley. Three arms, eyes. I think that's a... Three arms with eyes? I don't know. Something's not right there.
Yes, lass.
Levine? Not yet. Absolutely. Alright. Calisthenes. She adores me. Alright, no one has any opinions.
What's on your mind?
Okay. Chicken quest. Why is this still here? I already gave him that. Why is that even still there? The Memovira told me that the first castoff is alive. However, she will only reveal the first whereabouts if I can rescue one of her people, a scholar named Ishan. Apparently, Ishan was abducted by the Bloom and taken to its heart. The Memovira no longer knows how to reach the Bloom's heart, so I'll have to find a way myself. She suggested that I seek advice from someone who understands the Bloom well. My first idea on that is Dracogen.
Sure enough.
And Tiber knows it, but he didn't have anything to say. Hail again. My friend, how can I be of assistance to you today? I'd like to ask a few more questions. Right. This is all again. Just gonna get to that last. What about yourself? Yeah, how do I get to the heart of the Bloom?
Making a note.
He stares at you for a moment and licks his lips. At last, he replies, I must admit I do not know. This is knowledge I have sought and failed to acquire. I can only suggest that you ask someone closer to the Bloom than I, someone who is not the Memovira. Okay. That could be any one of a number of people. The Bloom guide in the next chamber, but let me ask Kian. She's been here for quite some time, I think. Yeah, no. Parson Flint? Now back to my clients. Huh. Just curious to see if, like, a lot of people have different things to say. They let you through the gate? What did you do? Who do you know? Will they let me in too? No visitors. I just came out of there. Dr. Bruska. She lets out a long sigh. You're new, so I'll tell you this once. The Memovira asked you to do something, yes? Well, you don't get to see her until you've done it. No exceptions. Please? No. She doesn't even look at you. Just curious if these people have anything different to say. Okay. Scrounge your own hole. Let's talk to Skeety. And well, I guess we'll continue on. It's too bad we can't use the katana as a like a shortcut through. Oh, okay.
Yes.
Let's talk to our friendly Bloom guide here. If he can't tell us, then he doesn't deserve the title of Bloom Guide.
Gladly.
Old Gristler. Hey, I wonder if the trading post is open. These guys are gone. Then we could buy stuff. We have like 5,000 shins. Gristler nods as you approach, smiling lopsidedly. Yep, I'm still here. Something you need? Where did the merchants go? On about their business. He gestures vaguely at the newly opened gateway to the trade post. Them sour fellas pay well, but that's all the good I have to say about them. Guess I'll be moving on soon. Got enough shins to hold me over for a while. Do you know how to reach the heart of the bloom?
Making a note.
Folks say there's a maw that will take you to the heart. If the stories are true, you can only see it if it wants you to. His easy smile fades. Never been there myself, but when I need something from the bloom, I go to the place where she's most likely to hear me. He nods his head toward the colossal statue on the other side of the vast interior space, the shrine of Chilla the Great. Maybe someone there can set you right. What will I find in the bloom's heart? I call myself a bloom guide because I know this sack of guts, but the deep places are different. More alive, more conscious, full of voices, packs from that wrap themselves in flesh so they can wander around and feed. The heart is where Memoviras are made, and unmade. He pauses uncomfortably. If you go down there, you ain't coming back until the bloom is finished with you, one way or another. Farewell. Yep, advice. Come see you again. Alright, let's, yeah, training post.
Ready.
See if we can buy some stuff. Well, Skady isn't much on stuff. Alright. The merchants have unpacked their wagon and repaired some of the broken tables you saw here earlier. Sure, the trade post is open again, but for how long? And how long till it eats us? Though the portal from Chirurgeon's slump is gone, it left a hideous scar behind. Funny, we got the fog of war back again. Okay, so we got human merchant, Rogellan merchant, and caravan guard here. Just gonna talk to all these guys first. Oh there! Trade's running smooth again. Or as smooth as it can around here. Hey, Lenine. Grunk, it says. It finally answered me. You again, huh? And I have all day to talk. Some of us have real jobs. Nice. Hello, merchant. We met with our contact in the Ascension, and it gave us a new set of baubles. The human opens a wooden display case that contains an array of crystalline artifacts, each of which appears unique. Normally, we sell them for ridiculous prices to the wealthiest families of Sagus, but for you, a discounted rate. Can you tell me a little bit more about your trading partner in the Ascension? It's less of a partner and more of a... Floating megalith, finishes the Vargellan. Ponderous stone and glittering scales, but all one being, a single intelligence. We pass through gate, search for familiar form. The Vargillon puts its hands around its eyes and mimes a slow and careful scan, right and left. Hard to find, never exactly the same. The human nods. Once we find this thing, we try offering it a variety of chemicals and powders. Sometimes it accepts them, or absorbs them anyway. In return, it excretes interesting things, with useful properties, most of the time. He snorts dismissively. It's a strange business we're in. Chemicals and powders, and then excretes things. Our trading partner is a floating megalith of sorts. We're not even sure it's alive, but we offer it various chemicals and powders. Sometimes it absorbs them, and in return it gives us useful things. He gestures at his display case, filled with weird crystalline objects. Let's trade. Alright, they only have a few things. We have a bedazzling flower. This is a human merchant. I wonder if the Vargellan merchant would be selling other things. Automatically succeed at the next persuasion, deception, or intimidation task. That can be useful. Three uses. Nice. This small, palm-sized crystalline structure has the solidity of a thin sheet of ice, threatening to crack and break in your hand, yet it houses untold social possibility. Upon its use, it generates a simulation of another possible response in the conversation that you're in. It determines the best way to say what you wish to convey, and seamlessly integrates this knowledge to you. However, upon such use, the bedazzling flower turns to dust. Mystical lore. Bedazzling flowers are rare and valued. One was long held by Forthos, a powerful but extremely socially awkward man. He planned to use it when his substantial means began to fail him. The legend says he ended up using it not in a business deal, but rather when talking to a small child on the street. It is unknown what was said, but they both went their ways after. Separate ways? He wasn't bringing him, like, back to his place, was he? Alright, well that's that, and then we have... Are these all ciphers? We got some kind of armor, though, too. Crystal Fortress. Negates the effects of Esoteri's and ranged attacks for 3 rounds. This dark purple crystal was placed into a synth-steel device, or perhaps the device was built around it. The crystal shimmers with barely restrained power, occasionally shifting as if testing the strength of its constraints. When you deactivate the container, the crystal loses its integrity, shattering into 2 parts, which in turn will shatter into 2, and so on and so forth, smaller and smaller. Smaller and smaller and smaller. With each breaking, the crystal unleashes a protective energy that wraps around the user, turning away incoming strikes, though it is not capable of turning away immediate attacks. Esoteri's and ranged attacks. Okay, not melee. Interesting. Yeah, I kind of want to get all these things. This stuff could be like... both of these could be handy for like... Well, this one could be handy for like a boss battle or something. Beads of Time Never Ending. Don't I have that? Yeah. I have my own. Plus 50% movement speed, 15% evasion and attacks. Yeah, I got that thing. Alright, 50%. Yeah, funny. Alright. Not only that, but I have it equipped. Frost Brooch. This is an artifact. 4 resistance deals 5 chemical damage to enemies entering or starting their turn in immediate range. Like per round, like continuously? That'd be awesome. This brooch has been carved from a substance that resembles ice in every respect other than temperature, yet it radiates a subtle warmth inwards, draining the warmth of the immediate environs. It absorbs a portion of the excess heat directly from the host's skin should the host become too warm. My mystical lore tells me that there is a legend of a young man who possessed a trinket made from warm ice that protected him from fire. He made his living performing death-defying pyrotechnic feats for the amusement of a paying audience. It was at one such show that a self-immolation trick went wrong and left him burning for far too long. Some accounts say that the heat was too much for the trinket and that he was killed in the blaze. Others say that the intense heat fused the trinket to his flesh. He lived, but was burnt beyond recognition and driven mad by the pain. Well, hopefully that doesn't happen with this thing. This doesn't really... Really? I guess draining the warmth of the environs gives the chemical damage to the people nearby. It doesn't really make sense. It seems like this is a description for something else, or this is a stats for something else. I'll get it now, because it's a cipher. I don't have to worry about it. Points of might. I might as well get it. Got so much friggin' money. We got Exuvia. Wait, I'm using spine armor. No, this is spine armor. And I'm using Exuvia. Okay, spine armor. See, I don't like the cost there. 10 armor, 6 resistance, but minus 6 to might and speed, minus 30% on esoteric attacks? Good god. When hit by a melee attack, spines spring out of the armor and impale the attacker. Deals 10 physical damage and inflicts bleeding. 10 physical damage per turn, active for 2 rounds, only usable by the last cast off. Well, that might be more useful to, like, a jack last cast off, or something. Or a warrior, whatever you call those ones. Because, yeah, not a good idea. Do I have some crap I don't want? I mean, I have oddities that can't be used for anything. But just in case it's something that, you know, might prove useful in a certain situation, you never know. I'll hold on to them until such time as I need more money to buy stuff. I want to see if the human merchant might have something different. Well, what we were looking at the human merchant. Let's see. Yeah, we were looking at him. Okay, what about the Vargellan then? Who is here? I'm automatically turning to... Okay. It's not a lot of stuff that they have, unfortunately. Now that we have so much money, I really want to go shopping. But we can't get back to where we came from. So... More spray flesh. Two. A couple of these. Guys who would need it. Cool. And as far as this stuff... We're full, but I really want one of those. At least... Hmm. It's gonna automatically go to me, right? I think.
All right.
So let's move this out. What is this? Panacea. I kind of want that. Non-combat. Have Calistes hold on to it. I can't hear you. You're echoing from the past, apparently. Oh, and
Yes.
Who else? Tiber. I don't want anyone to, like, have more than one over. So let's see what else we want to part with. That's the health. Reanimate the muscles. That's pretty cool. Changing tool. Give that to Aratus. It's obviously a bug with the game. I don't know why that happens. Okay, so now I can buy two and not be overloaded by two. Let's rock. Let's dance. Okay. Automatically succeed, that's powerful.
These ciphers are killing me.
You're right. You're only one over, right? Yeah. You're fine. We'll use that corpse thing in the next big battle. And that's it.
Allow me.
I'm kind of underwhelmed. That's the big trading post. Maybe they'll have more later. Okay, so stay tuned next time when we return to, what's her name's? The Shrine of Chilla. To find out what they know about the bloom. The heart of the bloom. See you next time, guys, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.